The primary driver for me when making a decision to pursue a PhD, and I think this needs to be a driver for everyone who thinks about this, is the desire to want to create new knowledge. So as a practicing clinician, for example, you see problems at the bedside every day. You see that we haven't yet figured out how to make big differences and to help people, and there are so many unanswered questions. And so to pursue a PhD means that you want to create new knowledge. You want to build upon what's known. You want to make a difference by discovering something that nobody else knows. And that is what's so exciting about the PhD. And so you discover something that nobody else knows, and that knowledge not only affects the person sitting right in front of you, the individual, but it can affect an individual that's a patient or a person who's not a patient, their families, and then larger communities, and then larger populations. So you have a huge impact that you can make, which is really bigger, perhaps, than the impact that you can make as a clinician on a day-to-day basis. So the program has two components, the coursework component and then the apprenticeship hands-on component. And so the coursework, there are core courses that all students take, and then there are elective choices that students can select based on their specific topic area. So they'll take a course in something that's very tailored to the kind of research that they're going to do. And so all of those courses are typically completed in the first 2 years, 2 to 3 years, depending upon whether a student is moving for a 3-year program or a 4-year program plan. At the same time, because again, you're matched with that mentor, you are embedded within that mentor's research program. And so you're helping that mentor to conduct their research. And so that's where you get this hands-on experience. And so that might mean that you are involved in all aspects of the process, beginning with you helping the mentor to perhaps write a grant, to get the funding, to do the work, and then actually doing the work. So, you know, recruiting participants, collecting data, managing that data, analyzing that data, and then participating in the steps of dissemination. So writing up the results in an abstract or a paper, and the students are co-authors and oftentimes primary authors on that work, and then also presenting that work at scientific conferences. So they really get to do the research, not just sort of learn about it or read about it in a book. The University of Michigan is a highly regarded research-intensive university that has a very strong reputation for bringing in lots of grant funding. And if a student wants to become a researcher, then you want to be in an environment where you are learning from the people who know how to do that and where there are resources to facilitate that. And so resources mean the people that have expertise that can teach you. It means administrative support, so, you know, a team of experts who know how to check all the boxes and submit the grants and can counsel you on, you know, what kind of grant and make certain that you do, you know, this piece and that piece and this piece. And so it takes a huge team of people who know what they're doing to facilitate success in research. And it's much harder to be successful at a university who hasn't done it and doesn't have, again, the depth of resources that we have here at Michigan. Within our school, we have world-renowned scientists who are deep experts in the area of science that they study. And so when someone pursues a PhD, probably more so than with any other academic degree, that mentor match is critical. And so you would choose to attend our school if we have a faculty person that has that deep expertise in the thing that you want to study. So again, it's scientific expertise, it's exposure to not only the faculty in our school, but then the exposure to other scientists throughout the university and throughout, you know, the national and international scientific community that are, again, world-renowned scientists have those connections with. So that's one reason. And I think if you are accepted into the PhD program in a full-time, either three-year or four-year program plan trajectory, you're completely funded. So that means that your tuition is paid for, you receive a monthly stipend, and then in addition to that, options to sign up for health insurance, not only for yourself, but for your family. And the reason why that funding package is so critical is that then that allows the student to really concentrate on their studies, to not have to work excessive hours in addition to completing their academic work, and so that they can get through efficiently and really come out of here at the end in a relatively short period of time and ready to move on to the next phase.